which they, she usually gives people to come up with those songs as God such a force.
No, no, we see an guy of heavens. We think you want to give the case and my yoke, but we show. No, when you're not quite an amateur queen, I'm not with the sin of Musuku on it.
Praise God.
Amen.
One of the few.
Amen.
Now, something, another tool which is usually associated with Valentine's Day is a Cupid.
Cupid.
Okay, Cupid is usually, I want to show you.
I believe
in love cards.
With your success,
you usually find there's a particular young child with some wings, and sometimes they hold an arrow.
With your personal letter, card in a super soletter, can locate a better.
Exactly. And at the end of that arrow is usually the sign of love.
Now you
praise God.
Amen.
And sometimes, okay, if you are a little bit far, you'll see some other time. Now, this is the shape of that particular child. Okay, fine. Ashes, you can show me. Now, this one is a bit clear. And that particular child is always seated in the sky.
Now we are kind of going to go kind of as well.
Praise God.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Cupid is the goddess of love intoxication.
Now you can kawana your panic who mean the ando came the window.
Cupid is a person, is a goddess.
Oh. What's all with our Cupid? Now can you guide your mother? I will mean the ando na mupali.
Exactly. She is the goddess of love intoxication, which includes lust, desire, and sexual immorality. Praise God.
Amen.
And Cupid is usually a son of Venus. Praise God.
Amen.
And that is why you see in the Valentine's Day, red color is usually very much praised. And every card has to contain that Cupid. Praise God.
Amen.
And if you go to Rome today,
you'll
find that statute there. Praise God.
Amen.
So it's good to understand that.
No, so kind of okay.
So during Valentine's Day, when you wear a red color, or when you see somebody wearing a red color, what they are usually doing is a worship to the goddess which you see, she's called Venus and Cupid.
With their Venus and Cupid.
Praise God. Now, I want us to look at how Valentine's Day is celebrated in the 21st century. Praise God.
Amen.
Now, I came to discover that wickedness is very expensive. Praise God.
Amen.
When I was researching on this, I came to discover that USA, last year they used $16 billion only on the Valentine's Day.
That is
last year. This year they used $18.2 billion.
Na yuma kona omana tobe yen billion yukuminanya, dollar billion yukuminanya.
That is the money used to, which was used to, that is rent hotels, buy cars, people to go for meals, trips and all that.
So basi ina mana tobe yen kwando mayi wakadi, mayi wamala, mayi tuando hotel ine, na mindo, na nini.
And here in Kenya, okay, the estimate which I have, it's not literally for what we spend as Kenyans, but I know one hotel, Kempinski, Villa Rosa, where Obama slept when he came on Kenya. That particular night, it was going for 2.4 million Kenyan shillings.
Ha. Praise
God.
Amen.
And the amazing things it, is this. Before that day, it had already been overbooked. Praise God. Bonus in view. And when you look at what our nations spent and how they behave, is an exact picture of what used to happen during the celebration of Lupercalia, that is Lupercalia festival. Praise God.
Amen.
Now, with that understanding, we come to a conclusion that Valentine's Day, its purpose and its plan is to promote prostitution, fornication, adultery, homosexuality and lesbianism. Praise God.
Amen.
And that is why from where we read, Paul told the church, do not be deceived by empty deceit. Or do not live by earthly principles. Because when you got born again,